Namaste! Welcome to Bhavna's Kitchen.
Quick recipes to satisfy your hunger. Delicious recipes to satisfy your crave. And healthy recipes to keep you fit.
Today I'm making instant dosa recipe. Jetpat dosa. So let's get started. Here I have 1 cup of rice flour, chawal atta, 1/2 cup of chickpea flour known as besan or Bengal gram flour, garbanzo beans flour. Mix all dry ingredients, all the flours first. Add salt to taste, and I'm also adding some spices, but it's totally optional. Here I have cumin powder, jeera powder, red chili powder, lal mirch, just pinch of a turmeric, haldi. Alright, so all dry ingredients are in to the bowl now. Now, because I'm making instant dosa, I still want to ferment this better. So what I'm going to use today is Eno fruit salt. This is also available at Indian grocers. And a little bit of a lemon juice. Now, if you don't want fermentation in your batter, that's fine too. But if you want kind of a traditional bubbles in your dosa, I recommend to ferment with the yeast or Eno and give it a try. If not, then you can always make without any fermentation even. And for the wet ingredient, all I need is water right now. Now, I also tried with coconut milk and dosa tastes so yummy, so do give it a try. A little water at a time and prepare smooth batter. I'm going to take out this can. Now using spatula, add more water. Once you know that all the lumps are broken, you can add more water and keep on adding water as you go. Exactly the same as the traditional dosa batter. The consistency should be the same as traditional dosa, not too thick, not too thin. Now at this time I'm going to heat up the pan, non-stick pan, onto the medium heat. And if you don't want to add any yeast or Eno, you can actually leave out overnight. Just add a little bit of a yogurt and leave this batter for about 6 to 8 hours or overnight, and that way it will be fermented. Okay, so I have got nice and smooth batter. Just a little bit more water, and I'm going to show you exactly how you want to keep the batter in order to prepare the perfect dosa. Okay, so you can see that now this is how the batter consistency is. Next, time to add Eno, the fruit salt. Add about 1 teaspoon of Eno fruit salt. Squeeze lemon juice. Now lemon juice just to activate the fruit salt. You don't need too much. So just about 3 to 4 drops of lemon juice. And now stir vigorously until it becomes light and fluffy. Take ladle spoon. Now this pan has got nice and hot, but in order to spread the batter properly, it's very important to bring down the temperature of the pan and then spread the batter. So you can see that I'm easily able to spread the batter. It's up to you whether you want to prepare thick or thin dosa. Smear a little bit of oil if desired. Move the pan around to get the oil all over and keep the temperature on a medium heat. You can see already bubbles. I'm going to flip on the other side because this is a little bit thicker dosa, and you can see that it looks perfect. So just to cook a little bit on the other side. Now if desired, you can make aloo masala, but I'm just going to spread a little bit of a chutney, and this is a spicy red chili peanut chutney. I have already shared the recipe. And usually the other side of the dosa do not need to be cooked, but if desired you can flip on the other side and cook. But this is how I usually do. If you cook on a medium heat, then dosa will be well done. When dosa is done, it will be easier to peel. You can see that it peels off easily from the pan. Now because I have spread it very thin in some places, it's gonna be broken. But look at this dosa. Doesn't it look exactly the same made with the traditional way? Bring down onto the serving plate. And look at this dosa. Doesn't it look just like exactly made with a traditional dosa batter? This dosa comes out crispy as well. I hope you can hear the crunch, soft crunch. So I hope I made it easier for you to prepare jhatpat dosa. Thank you for watching and I will see you soon with another great recipe.